So now starting with sixth chapter. So the sixth chapter name is Effects of Electric Current. So we have learnt in last lecture or in last chapter Joule's law. Okay, do you remember Joule's law? So what it says? So it says whenever the electric current passes through the circuit, it is opposed by the resistance. Now consider this is our circuit. Okay, this is the voltage and this is the current I flowing through it and this is the resistance. So this is our electric circuit. So whenever the current I flows through the electric circuit, it opposed by the resistance. So every conductor has some resistance, so it is opposed by resistance of the circuit. So energy required, so there is some energy that is required to overcome this resistance. Okay, so that means जब ये current इस circuit में flow होगा तब ये resistance की वजह से oppose होगा ये current, तो इसे कुछ ना कुछ तो energy डालना पड़ेगा इसके आगे आने के लिए, right? So energy is required to overcome the resistance. And this is converted it into heat. So just remember, whenever the current flows through a conductor, it produces a heat. So you can take any example. So basically take example of your computers or take example of charger. So they get a little bit heated up. Okay, so whenever we use it more, so it get heated. सभी equipments थोड़ा बहुत तो ही गरम हो जाते हैं. ओके, सो नाउ दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द जूल्स लॉ. इन दिस चैप्टर व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू सी इज हीटिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट, केमिकल इफेक्ट ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट, फिजिकल इफेक्ट ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. सो फिजिकल इफेक्ट मीन्स व्हाट व्हाट विल करंट इफेक्ट ऑन आवर ह्यूमन बॉडी, एक्सरे इफेक्ट ऑन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट, मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट ऑन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. Okay, now the question will be asked, explain any effect of electric current or explain effects of electric current. So first what you have to do is just write, mention these effects and you can explain any two of them. So I hope you have understood the basic concept what is in this chapter. So this chapter is just about what will happen or whenever the current flows through the circuit, heat is produced. Okay, now see one by one. So we'll see first heating effect of an electric current. So as I said, according to Joule's law, whenever the electric current passes through the circuit, it is opposed by the resistance. It is opposed by the resistance, and due to this, energy is required to overcome this resistance. Okay, so this is converted into heat, and we know we have learnt in a last lecture that heat is directly proportional to I square R T, where I is nothing but it is current, R is the resistance, and time is T in seconds. Okay, so from here we'll understand what is the heating effect of electric current. So the effect electric current pass through the electric circuit produces many different effects. So these effects are very useful in our electrical appliances. We use these effects so in our daily appliances. So the basic appliances of heating effect are electric heater. So you know the electric heater. So what we do with that heater? We heat the water. So what are the components? Just it consists of rod. So it just I'll draw the diagram here. So it consists of rod. Okay, so this is the diagram. So this is the diagram of electric heater. Okay, so what happens when the current flows through this? This is the rod, conductor, it is conductor. So whenever the current flows through this, this material is heated up. Okay, so due to this heating, what happens? Our water gets heated. So this is the use of heater or heating effect of electric current in our daily appliances. So there are many appliances that we use in our regular usage that are electric heater, electric geyser, electric stove, electric iron. So we use the press. So that press also works on the heating effect of an electric current. Okay. So there are many examples heating effect. So the electric oven is also dependent on this law or heating effect. Electric toaster, lamps, electric welding, electric kettle, room heater, electric hot plate. So these are all the examples of heating effect of electric current. So I will explain it once again. So what it does mean by heating effect of an electric current. So whenever the electric current flows through electric circuit, it is opposed by the resistance. So whenever the current flows through the circuit, it is opposed by the resistance. To overcome this resistance, energy is required. Okay. So this energy is converted it into heat. Okay. So whenever the current flows through the conductor, heat is produced. So this is all about the heating effect of electric current. I hope you have understood. Now we'll see the chemical effect of an electric current. So in this, what happens when electric current passes through some chemical solutions? So now consider a chemical solution. So this is the chemical solution here. This is the pot and this is the chemical solution. Okay. And now when we give the supply to this solution, whenever the electric current passes through this chemical solution, chemical reactions takes place. Okay, so there are some examples: electrolysis, electroplating, electro refining of metals, and battery charging. So we are going to see this in our next chapter. We will see this in depth. So in this chapter, it is no need to go in depth. So just remember, whenever the electric current is passed through the chemical solution. So whenever we give the electric current to any chemical solution, chemical reactions takes place. Okay. So this is about chemical effect of electric current. Now physical effect of an electric current. So what is meant by physical effect? So what will be the effect of current when it flows through our human body? Obviously we'll get shock, right? So our human body is conductor of electricity. That means current can flow from our body. It is good conductor of electricity. The current can very easily pass through the body if any part of body touches the live part of electricity. Okay. So whenever we touch the phase, the phase wire. So whenever we touch the live part, that means consider this is our body, or this is our one appliance. Okay. And this is insulation and this is the body of our appliance, and this body has the electric current, or it is the live part of this. Okay. So whenever we touch any live part of any appliances, then electric current flows through our body. Okay. So how that electric current passes? So when the electric current flows through the circuit, whenever the circuit is closed circuit. Okay. Now consider this circuit. Okay. So this is our circuit. This is the current I flowing through it. Okay. So will this current flow through this circuit? No. Why? Because this is open circuit. So how current will go forward here? This is not a closed circuit. This is open circuit. So whenever the path is completed, now the current will flow. Okay. Circuit is closed circuit. Okay. It is getting the return path. But here this is open. Now if I attach the switch here, then this is the open. this is open, right? So the no current will flow forward. So this is open circuit, and whenever the switch is closed, now consider this case, this switch is closed, then current will flow forward. So the current flows whenever there is closed circuit. Okay, so now consider this is human standing on ground. Okay, and this is the appliance, or consider this is the live part. So whenever we touch this live part, we get shock. Okay, so how this circuit is incomplete? Now this circuit is also incomplete because this is the live part. Okay, so now this circuit is incomplete. Whenever this person touches this live part, then what will happen? This circuit will get completed, right? So the circuit gets completed when the human touches the ground. So human is standing on ground. Okay, so human is standing on ground, and the current will flow through our body. First the current will flow from our body and then to ground. That means it will complete the circuit. Why I have one question for you. Why that birds don't get electric shock when they are sitting on the wire? Okay, now consider they are sitting on the wire. So why they don't get any shock? Because the circuit is not completed. If they touch the ground at the same time, then they will get shock. But the here circuit is not completed, the potential difference is zero, and they will not get shock. Obviously they will not get shock because the circuit is incomplete. Whenever this will touch the ground, then circuit gets completed and the birds will get shock. So whenever we touch the ground and we touch the live part, our circuit gets completed and we get shock. Okay, so if the current through our body, so the current from our body is more than 15 milliampere, then the body gets the shock, that is severe shock. Okay, so our body resistance, average resistance of our body is 50,000 ohm. Okay, when body is dry, so when our body is dry, resistance is 50,000. But when our body is wet, that means if our body is wet, if we are in contact with water or our body is wet, then what will happen? This resistance will get reduced. That means the opposition will get reduced and there are more chances that we will get the more severe shock. So at the wet condition, the resistance becomes 1000 ohm. And the shock is severe when our body is wet. Okay, this is about physical effect on electric current. Okay, so we'll see from first heating effect of an electric current. So we learned Joule's law. According to it, whenever the current flows through electric circuit, it is opposed by the resistance, and this opposition produces energy, and this energy is converted into heat. Okay, so this is heating effect of electric current. This effect is used in electric heaters, geysers, electric stove, toaster. Okay, chemical effect of electric current. So whenever we give the electric current in any chemical solution, then chemical reactions takes place. This is about chemical effect. Physical effect: our human body is good conductor of electricity. Human body is conductor of electricity. So whenever we touch the live part, there are chances to get shock to that person. Okay, now we'll see X-ray effect on electric current. So X-ray effect of an electric current means what? So by some machines, a very high frequency voltage is generated. So some machines create high frequency voltage. Okay, when this high frequency voltage is applied to X-ray vacuum tube, so there is a vacuum tube. Okay, X-ray vacuum tube, and whenever the machines that produces high frequency voltage, and this generated voltage, whenever we apply it, this high frequency voltage we apply to X-ray vacuum tube. special type of rays are produced. So whenever the high frequency voltage is applied to X-ray vacuum tube, then special type of rays are produced. These rays are known as X-rays. So we all know X-rays are used in hospitals for various X-ray photography. Okay, so what we have to understand from this X-ray effect on electric current, that some machines produce high frequency voltage. Okay, so this high frequency voltage is applied to X-ray vacuum tube. So whenever we apply high frequency voltage to X-ray vacuum tube, special types of rays are produced. These rays are called X-rays. These are used in hospitals. Okay, this is about X-ray effect of an electric current. Now we'll see magnetic effect of an electric current. So this is a very important and this is used in various electrical appliances, magnetic effect of an electric current. So now we are going to see magnetic effect of an electric current. So whenever current passes through conductor wire, magnetic field is produced around the conductor. Now consider, this is our conductor. Okay, so this is our conductor. So whenever the current flows, so this is the current I. So whenever the current flows through the any conductor, then the magnetic field is produced around this conductor. Remember this, whenever the conductor, so whenever the current passes through the conductor wire, magnetic field is produced around the conductor. So this is approved experimentally. So what we have to do, we have to take one conductor, okay, and we have to give it some amount of current, or we have to provide the supply to that conductor. And what we have to do, just hold a magnetic needle. So we have to hold the magnetic needle near this conductor. So what will happen, this magnetic needle will get deflected. So from this deflection of this magnetic needle, what we understand, that there is magnetic field produced, right? So magnetic field is produced around the conductor. So this magnetic field that is produced around the conductor, it also has some direction. Okay, so this direction depends upon the direction of the current in the conductor. So we are going to see this, how to know the direction of this. So we'll see it further. Okay, so whenever the direction of current is changed, so whenever the direction of current changes, then the magnetic field produced, so this the magnetic field is produced around this conductor, will also change. Okay, we'll see now. So now consider, so whenever the straight conductor carries current, magnetic field is produced around it in a circular line of force. So consider this is the conductor. Okay, so this is the conductor, and whenever the current flows, so this is the current I flowing through it, then what happens? Magnetic field lines are produced around the conductor in circular line of forces. So you can see in the diagram how they are produced, right? So the direction of these lines is found by right hand rule. So this is our right hand rule. Now take your right hand and then just make in this form. Okay, so this thumb, so you can see the thumb. Thumb shows the direction of current, and this curved fingers shows the direction of magnetic field. Okay, now our current is above, means going upwards. Then what is the direction of magnetic field? This is this way. Okay, so the direction is in this way. So now consider, so this is our current is going above, upward in direction. So this is our right hand, and we'll just put our thumb in the current direction. Then this is the way, so in this direction will be the magnetic field. Okay, so the direction of lines is found by right hand rule as shown in figure. If the direction of current is shown by the thumb, the direction of fingers give the direction of magnetic flux lines. So now if you have understood this, so in this diagram what is happening, the current is in above direction. So according to our right hand, so this is the right hand rule. So our thumb will indicate the current and these fingers, these curved fingers will give the magnetic flux direction. So this is in this direction. Okay. Now this considered, figures. So in this, there are a dot and this is cross, right? The symbol dot means, so this is the dot, means the current is coming out, and cross means current is going in. So now this is our page and this current is coming outside. So according to our right hand, we'll take the fingers outside of this page, and then the fingers, these curved fingers are like this. So our current direction is like this. Now this cross means the current is going inside, so our thumb will indicate the current. So this and this is our direction, right? So our curved fingers are indicating this way. So this is the direction. Okay, so this is clockwise and this is anticlockwise. Are you getting this? Okay, so now magnetic field due to coil having number of turns, we have seen this conductor, right? So this is the straight conductor. Now what we'll do, we'll make the coil, that means we'll make the round of that coil and of that conductor and we'll make form it in coil. Okay, so this is how the coil looks. Okay, so whenever this we make the coil and we give the current, whenever the current flows through the coil, magnetic field lines, you can see here, so the magnetic effect is produced. So the number of turns and the magnetic field has some relation. Okay, the strength of magnetic field depends upon the number of turns of the coil. So the number of turns are more, then the magnetic field produced will be more. Field strength is directly proportional to the N into I. Okay. Now, if the coil, whenever the coil passes the current, then what happens? Magnetic field is produced. Okay, so this is the another concept and this is the another concept. So what we have to do, we have to take one iron rod. So this is iron rod. Now, so this is our just a simple iron rod. Okay, don't see this picture, just look at this picture. So this is the iron rod. Okay, this is the iron rod, and what we have to do, we have to wound the coil over this iron rod. What we did, we first took the iron rod, and then what we did, we wound this coil around this iron rod, and then we gave the supply, and this is the current I flowing through this coil. So because of this current flowing through this coil, what will happen, this iron rod now, this will act as magnet. Okay, there will be polarities generated on this magnet, north and south. Okay, so just remember, whenever the iron rod, when we take iron rod and wound the coil around this iron rod, then what happens? And when we give the current, when we give the supply, then what happens? This iron rod gets converted, or it behaves like a magnet. And this arrangement is called as electromagnet. So you are going to learn this, or this electromagnet term is going to come many times in your further lectures. So just remember this. So what we did in this, we just took one iron rod, and what we did, we wound the coil over this iron rod, and we gave the supply. So when we give the supply, this iron rod behaves like a magnet. It will produce north and south poles. Okay, so this will behave like a magnet, and this is called as electromagnet. And the magnetic effect of electric current is also made using our following equipments. So the fan, it also has electric effect of magnetic effect of electric current. in fans, bells and transformers. So we are going to learn this in further lecture. Okay.